So I think the budget is a very interesting effort this time. It's a little bit different from previous budgets. I think the finance minister spent a fair bit of time talking about the plans for the next 5 years. In that, she outlined a number of different areas at which the government wants to put a lot of emphasis in. Clearly, reform of the financial sector with further capitalization of the banking system, improvement in the condition of the non-banking financial companies, very critical areas because that is the underlying factor behind the entire economy. So that's an area that really needs to be set right. In addition to that, she spoke at length about the infrastructure build-out that needs to happen in the country over the next 5 years, the kind of investments that are required, and how to raise capital for the sector. She also gave the concept of one nation, one grid in multiple areas like gas, water, power, roads, airline connectivity, and so on. And those are aspirational, those are targets that have now been set, and those are the targets that we have to now meet. She also looked at a couple of areas for giving special fillip. For example, affordable housing was one area, and the second was the electric vehicle area. In fact, they also talked about trying to come up with global manufacturing bids, giving incentives for manufacturing companies from on the basis of global bids to come into India and basically set up manufacturing capacities under really the Make in India program. That I think is also a very interesting program. It will lead to the creation of several lakhs of jobs, which is of course, as we all know, very critical. Affordable housing was another sector that was given a lot of prominence. And the finance minister also talked about the reform of the distribution companies in the power sector, which is very critical to encourage the growth of the power sector going forward. So I think a multiple number of areas were covered by the finance minister in the budget. And all of these hopefully will now come to fruition in actions that the government will have to take outside of the budget presentation. So we're very hopeful that all of those steps will get taken. And we're looking forward to working with the government to have those steps undertaken so that, again, the corporate sector can start really investing for further growth and also that there is consumption demand pickup. And the economy then ends the year with 7% growth as outlined by the economic survey and fundamentally gets onto a trajectory of 8 to 9% growth in the years after that, which hopefully then meets the government's target that they've now spelled out very clearly of getting to a $5 trillion economy in the next 5 years' time. So I think a very progressive budget in that regard, and we look forward to working with the government to try to implement a lot of the schemes that have been mentioned and talked about. Thank you.